Hi everyone, I'm Priyanka and you're welcome to the Terrace Kitchen. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to make delectable chocolate cheesecake. Let's get started. Here I've got 12 digestive biscuits. I love using digestive biscuits in my cheesecake because they are less sweet. But you may use a chocolate flavored biscuit in this recipe because we are making chocolate cheesecake. Now I'm grinding this to a fine powder. After grinding, even if you see big pieces of biscuits inside and between, you can take them out and crush with your fingers. Here I've got melted butter. I'm using salted butter, so here I've got 2 tablespoons. Don't worry, salted butter goes really well with this base. Give this a good mix. And this mixture is ready. It should look crumbly like this. This is my cake tin. It's a 7-inch cake tin where the base comes out. I've lined it with parchment paper at the bottom, and on the sides I have lined acetate sheets. You may use a springform mold, but line it with parchment paper and acetate sheet. Instead of acetate sheet, you can also line the mold with parchment paper on the sides too. Spread the mixture evenly. Spread the mixture evenly before you start pressing, and this way you would get a nice and even layer of biscuit at the bottom. Press with a spoon or a bowl and flatten the base. It should become firm and come together. Once done, put this in your refrigerator for at least 15 to 20 minutes. Next, in a bowl, I'm adding 1/2 cup dark chocolate. This is 45% dark. To this, I'm adding 2 tablespoon milk. You may use cream. Now I'm microwaving this for 1 to 1.5 minutes, or you can heat this on a double boiler, that is a bowl of hot water and another bowl on top of it in which you would have your chocolate and milk. Now let this come to room temperature. This would thicken more as it comes to room temperature. Here I've got 150 gram cream cheese. You can use any brand's cream cheese, or you can use your homemade cream cheese. I have not posted my cream cheese recipe yet, but yes, I have plans to post it. Whip your cream cheese and add 2 tablespoons powdered sugar. Initially, you would find it difficult to beat it, but if you have an electric beater, you can directly start with your electric beater and it would be easier. Keep it aside. Here I've got whipping cream. I'm using non-dairy because it's more stable. It's already sweetened. When I say stable, it holds its shape and your cheesecake would come out really well. After whipping the cream to stiff peaks, add the whipped cream cheese. Chocolate ganache that has cooled down and thickened. So everything is cold, the whipped cream is cold, the cream cheese is cold, the ganache has thickened, has come to room temperature. So everything needs to be cold, otherwise your cheesecake would not set. I was talking about the use of non-dairy whipping cream in this recipe. Because non-dairy cream is stable, your cream cheese, I mean this cheesecake, would hold its shape without adding any agar-agar or gelatin. This looks perfect. Next step is to transfer this chocolate mixture to the set mold. So I've taken my mold out of my refrigerator and now I'm going to add a layer of this cream cheese mixture on it. An offset spatula would make this task easier. You can use a small offset spatula. Actually, this is a butter knife, but I also have an offset spatula, and in this case, offset spatula works really well. Now set this in your refrigerator for 1 to 2 hours and then we'll add a layer of ganache on top of it. So here I've got 1/2 cup chocolate, this is 45%, 3 tablespoon milk this time. You may add 2 tablespoon milk and make a thicker ganache. So I'm going to microwave this for 1 to 1.5 minutes, or you can heat this on a double boiler, that is a bowl of boiling water below and another one on top, in which you will have your chocolate and milk. Mix till the chocolate melts and the ganache becomes smooth, and then let it cool down completely. It's very important that your ganache cools down to room temperature before you spread it on your cheesecake. After pouring, spread it evenly. And then again, pop your cheesecake in your refrigerator for at least 2 to 3 hours. I know it takes time, but the result is totally worth it. It's time to take this cheesecake out of the mold. Because the base comes out, I'm placing a glass below. If you use a spring form mold, it would be easier for you to demold it. Since we've added a soft ganache layer on top, use a knife so that your acetate sheet comes out easily without pulling your chocolate out. This would serve 6 to 7 people only if you share your cheesecake with them. Slice the cheesecake and serve it right away. Make sure you keep the remaining cheesecake in your refrigerator, not freezer. If you like this recipe, give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to Terrace Kitchen for more such wonderful recipes. Give this recipe a try and enjoy!